Bande Guru Pada Dandam Bhakta Binda Samanitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Bande Nitta Nanda Sahoditam Sri Nanda 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 Bande Radhika Charano Dayam Gopijano Samayuktam Binda Vanam Manu Vāñśā-kalpa-taru-vaśya-kipā-sindhu-vivaśa patitānaṁ pāvane bhaveshna-vibhyo namo namah mukhaṁ karoti vācālaṁ pangung laṁ haitigiram yat-kipātamahaṁ bandhi paramānanda-vādhavam brindhāvi-tulsi-dev-vai-piyāvai-keśvasya Shna Bhakti Bhadi Devi Sattva Bhattvai Namo Namah Narayana Namaskritta Naranchaiva Narottamam Deving Swarasvati Vyasam Tato Jayo Mudire Sankirtane Krishna Kathopadeshe Gauriya Patrasya Prakasanecha Sadhanurakta Guru Bhakti Yukta Bhakti Pramodakshya Jagod Varanya Dhayam Sada Paribhavagnam Avishtaduham Tethas Padam Siva Virinchanatam Saranyam Bhittatiham Panatapal Bhavadiputam Bande Mahapurusate Charanarvindam Yat Pad Pallavanakachandamanichataya Vishwarijita kimapikubhavadushvadarshi Purna nuragara sa sagara saramurti Saradhikamai kadakipam karosh Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadihi Gaura Bhakta Binda Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Ajahnulammita-bhujo-kanaka-bodhato Saṅkita-naik-vitaro-kamala-yatākṣa Viṣyāmbaru-dija-varu-yuga-dharma-pālo Bande-yagat-priyakaro Karuna-bhataro Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Hare 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 Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Namami Gange Tava Pad Pankajam Sura Surair Vandito Diparupam Bhuktin Chamuktin Chukatada Sinitam Bhavanurupena sada naranam Ganga taranga ramaniya jata kalabam Gauri nirantara vibhushi tobam bhagam Narayano priyamananga madapaharam Varanasi purapati bhajavi shanatham Vāgī sajasya badane lakshmīr jasya ca bhakshasi Jasyāste hide sambhīr tvam nishingamaham bhaji Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rām, Hare Rām Ram Ram Hare Jang Brahma Varanendaru dhamaruto stunvanti divai stavai vedai sanga padakrama panishadai gayanti yam samaga dhyanavasthita tadgati namanasa pashvanti yam yogina jasyam tamna viduhu surasuragana devayatasmai namah Yang Brahma Varunendra Rudamaruto Stunmanti Dibbai Stavai Vedai Sangha Padakrama Panishadai Gayanti Yam Samaga Dhenavastita Tadgatina Manaswa Pashvanti Yam Yogina Yasyam Tamna Viduhu Sura Suragana Devayatasmai Namaha Gaudiya Goshtipati Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, Jagadguru told, there is nothing attractive in this material world for which Guru Vaishnava can feel attraction. Gauriya Goshtipati, Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, Jagadguru told, there is nothing such attractive thing in this material world for which Paramahansa Guru Vaishnava, Niskinchan Guru Vaishnava can feel attraction. They can feel attraction only for Krishna Charan, Gauranga Charan, nothing else. But this is not the case with bonded soul. Bonded soul always try to search out utility of their life. If they find enjoyment, material enjoyment, everything, all different kind of demands, if they can get fulfilled in their life, they feel this is the utility of their life, to enjoy as much as possible material enjoyment they like to arrange in their life. That is their goal. Bonded soul is just like, you know, bonded soul all there in a jail is like a jail set by Mahadevi, Durga, Durga. They are already inside a fort, trapped. They think we are free to do anything. They always think we are free to do anything, whatever we like, we are enjoying freedom. But foolish and idiot, they don't understand this is not freedom. Freedom of your material mind, freedom of your material body is not actually freedom. Is that all? After that, what to do? Where to go? How to lead? Because Jivatma, you already know, eternally present. You cannot point out such a time where your Jivatma, I mean the Jivatma inside you, me, was not there. Eternally present means eternally, 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 all the time. The sloka I started with is very important. Mankind with their limited capacity and understanding are absolutely at loss to gaze Him, I mean Supreme Lord, gaze Him. Innumerable glories which are you know, puzzling for us. Even those great, you know, those who are demigods, they are, and sages, they also get puzzled. They cannot understand. All varieties of Leela, perplexing, all. Even those sages, those demigods, they can, and they get puzzled. I offer my innumerable prostrate obeisances unto the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord, whom Brahma, Vishnu, Indra, Varun, Marutas extol by singing His divine pastimes, whom Vedas together with Upanishads and other complementary texts always try to sing His glories, try to highlight His glories. Those excellences are sung by the followers of Samveda, whom the yogi is behold in their minds to get lost in complete contemplation and the limit and extent of those glories are incomprehensible even to the gods and rishimanis all. I already told, infinity varieties are there coming from Supreme Lord. Infinity varieties. Advaita still is Advaita Gantatta. Still there is no hamper of Advaita Gantatta. Shakti Shakti Mator Abhed, already I told. Specially Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to establish this Achintya Vedavet Tattva. If you realize this Achintya Vedavet Tattva, then there is no problem, no doubt can stand inside your heart. Advaita Tattva. Infinity diversity, simultaneously is, you know, same and different from Supreme Lord. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagadguru told, Srila Prabhupada has given example that jivas are placed into three different conditions like bonded condition, marginal condition and free condition, mukta. In Bhagavan itself, those three conditions are resting directly or indirectly. Be careful. Directly or indirectly. If at all it is taken as granted that the existence of this bonded condition has not been derived from the Supreme Lord, then in that case its existence becomes false. Those Mayavadis saying that the material bondage condition, bondage condition is totally false. But Bhagavan Sri Krishna Chaitanya Dev, he has said that this is not at all false, but unstable by nature, or can get destroyed in course of time. This much we can say, but not false. So we see that the existence of bonded condition also coming originally from the Supreme Lord. The transformation of Shakti of Supreme Lord creating these three worlds, 14 worlds I mean. Supreme Lord never undergo any influence. Supreme Lord Himself never undergo any influence by those three conditions like bondage condition, tatastha condition or free condition. Bhagavan is also you can remember I was speaking from Chaitanya Charitamrita. Amito jagate boshi jagat amate na ami jagate boshi na jagat amate. Bhagavan speaking Chaitanya Charitamrita Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami. Here begin. Bhagavan speaking, I am already in this creation. And Jagat inside me. And next stage speaking, I am not anywhere there. Oh, the Jagat is also not there. I have some special sarup, pure. You have to understand this point. Bhagavan speaking this way. Or Bhagavan always going to show equal attitude to everybody. Previous day I was discussing about these topics, how those wicked people can say Bhagavan is responsible for all those different kind of sufferings of Bhadrajiv, because why not Bhagavan can make them free? So many question answer going on. Also in this context I was bound to discuss so many points from Vedanta, you can remember. Vaishamma naighirna, vaishamma naighirne na sapekkatvat tatahi darshayati. Again I discussed, you can remember, na karma abhibhagaditi chet nanadityat nadatte kasyachit papam na chaiva sukritim vibhum. Nadatte kasyachit papam na chaiva sukritim vibhu. Nadatte kasyachit papam na chaiva sukritim vibhu. Agyaneno avritam jnanam teno muhyanti jantabha. Also I was discussing about prithak upadesha, prithak upadeshat from Vedanta sutra, even from Gita. I am bound to speak the samo aham sarva bhuteshu na me desho asti na priya je bhajanti tumam bhakta mai tesu chaapi aham. Follow. Samo aham sarva bhuteshu na me desho asti na priyaha je bhajanti tumam bhakta mai tesu chaapi aham. Follow. This way actually I was discussing that Bhagavan always going to show equal attitude, Bhagavan having equal attitude all the time. Now I am equally present in all beings. There is no hateful or dear to me. They, however, who devoutly worship me, you know, abide me, I too stand revealed in them. Follow. I am equally present in all beings. There is none hateful or dear to me. They, however, who devoutly worship me, abide me, and I too stand revealed in them all the time. Nadatika sajit papam na chaiva sukritim vibhum agyaneno avritam jnanam tenam yanti jantabha. By this sloka also I wanted to speak, Bhagavan is not at all responsible for any fanciful work done by any jiva, because Bhagavan not going to interfere with their freedom. Chid atma means freedom already there. Bhagavan don't like to interfere, but still Bhagavan like to see they themselves, if they can voluntarily going to submit unto my lotus feet, they like to do seva. Though many times Bhagavan told in different shastras, especially in Gita also, Bhagavan speaking, Mad jaji mang namaskuru, come to me, you know, you worship me, you pay dandavat to me, but people misunderstand what to do. This way I was giving judgment that jivatma, according to their karmaphal, Bhagavan going to give result. Also, as a negative argument, somebody is speaking, then where is the absolute power of Supreme Lord? If Bhagavan at all going to give result according to the karma fall of jiva, then what is the utility of Bhagavan? Then the Bharadipita also give an example. What wrong in it? Some king going to give remuneration, or some king going to give remuneration to somebody, and going to give punishment to somebody according to their activities. For this reason, we cannot say the kingship of king already gone. What is this? Kingship of king gone. How I can say? So power is there. Similarly, Bhagavan, his absolute power is there, omnipresent, all powerful. You know, janma adasya yatyanamaya ditarasya savigga sarato. At a time in infinity world, infinity jivas, what they are doing, at a time Bhagavan can take information. No, it is known to Bhagavan. So anyway, we should not express any doubt about it, because that's why I was bound to start with this sloka, yang brahma varunan, so that you can understand about the infinity power of Supreme Lord, infinity jnana, oishajyasya samagrasya vidyasya jasasya sriya jnana vairagyasya iva saro iti bhaga ingana. All complete jnana, all complete detachment vairagya, all complete appliances, everything, you know. Follow, everything in complete. Sarai Sajya Purna Bhagavan, six appliances there in complete form in Bhagavan Vishnu. Vishnu means Krishna. And Krishna having some more special quality regarding attraction, how he can attract whole world, how it is possible. It is a question of direct experience. If somebody like to fight, then I already told logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of that absolute truth. Now point is there, the transformation of Shakti of Supreme Lord creating these 14 worlds. Supreme Lord never undergo any influence by those three conditions, like bonded condition, tatastha condition, or free condition, mukta condition. Moreover, these three stages, bonded stage, tatastha stage, free stage, all the three stages have been derived from him, from nowhere else. Be careful about it. Simultaneously, how it is possible? Bhagavan is present everywhere. Bhagavan is nowhere. But yes, these all contradicted points can get absolute samadhan, solution for that absolute world. Absolute world. But in material world, contradicted point means contradictory points. It can never be in line with solution. Supreme Lord, his external potency or Maya Shakti has been transformed as the material world. Supreme Lord, his external potency or Maya Shakti has been transformed as this material world. His internal potency has been transformed as Vaikuntha Jagat or Galaka, Vaikuntha in general, I can see. All those are beyond Maya. Follow. This internal potency and external potency is there already. In between both of them, there is another potency. Shakti is called Tatastha Shakti. I already told, again I can discuss day by day, I can show that Tatastha Shakti directly not there inside Krishna's heart. Not there, but it is Shakti. Because Adhyagan Tatta, where can go? This Tatastha Shakti also there. But Tatastha Shakti has no direct existence inside the heart of Krishna. Because inside the heart of Krishna, there is Sarup Shakti. If at all Tatasa Shakti is coming from heart of Krishna, there is already existence of Sarup Shakti. So why they are lacking bhakti? Where is there no bhakti there? Why? For infinity period, how they are bonded, how they are averts. Krishna Bhuli. Krishna Bhuli. Say Jeev Anadi Bahirmukh. Atoye Mayathara Day. I already proved that day. There is no contradiction, no fighting, nothing. Baladev Buddha Vasan already proved. There is no question of any fighting. If somebody is speaking that karma, initially only Brahma was there. So where from this karma coming? It is the question. Then Baladev Buddha Vasan by Shastra going to prove Upanishad Vedanta that Bhagavan is eternal. Jivas are eternal, follow, and karma is also eternal, eternally existing, bonded soul eternal, karma eternally present, ana, for eternal period, karma is there. Karma is literally anadi, it is without any beginning at all. Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur was bound to give such description of anadi karma that way as a figurative description so that jivas cannot blame Supreme Lord for their suffering. And what Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking more I can discuss regarding this matter, suffering. Apparently we see jivas are suffering, what Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking I can again discuss. Govinda Vasa commentary by Baladev Vidyabhushan, those two Vedanta Sutras 2134, 2135 already discussed. He has given, you know, example has been given by him as evidence and also as a real explanation of why and how karma is anadi. Also the same thing he says in his commentary in Bhagavatam 5.5. Follow. You know, he has given same explanation, you know, also he has given explanations of Vedanta Sutra 2.3.26 about jivas turning away from God. Her natural, eternal, spiritual consciousness becomes covered up, and if she turns towards God, then it can get manifested. If ever, can get covered by Maya. Avidya, I also explained that day. Nitya mukta, nitya Krishna charane unmukh. Krishna parishad naam bhunje sevasukh. Nitya badha Krishna haitya nitya bahirmukh. Nitya sansar bhunje narakadi dukh. Nitya mukta never got the taste of maya sambandha. They eternally busy with nitya seva sukha. Sukha means bliss, nitya seva sukha of Bhagavan. They are known as Parshad. I already discussed, I give reminder. But those nitya badha jivas are eternally averse to Krishna seva for anadikal. So they are suffering. Samsar duksha, material pain, material duksha, forever. Sometime going to hell, sometime going to heaven, here, there, poor, rich, king, you know, beggar, woman, man, tiger. This way, all different, 84 different species of journey is going on. Follow. This way I was bound to discuss all in, you know. So, all slokas given I already given example before. So be careful. All the above evidence, as shown by you, as shown by me, you should remember, should be treated according to my detailed explanation given before. Because the bonded condition of jiva originally coming from Supreme Lord, I already told. As also, I already said in my previous Harikatha that this is the final Siddhanta of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur as per the commentary of Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhya 22, 11 and 12. I already just now I told. Nitya Mukta Krishna Charan, I already explained. Karma, how anadi, now question coming, time. We don't understand what you mean by time. We cannot understand. And what Bhaktivinoda Thakur is speaking about time factor in eternal Jagat, about time factor, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is speaking. Follow. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking about time factor. And the question was there by one devotee who put in question. Follow. Srinath. That earlier you have explained, Gurudev, that the spiritual world and the jivas are eternal. Raghunath Baba giving answer in Siva Sangam. How is it possible for eternal entities to have birth? Same question coming with you, huh? Inside your heart, na? Raghunath Babaji Maharaj going to give answer. And the devotee asking, earlier you have explained that the spiritual world and the jivas are eternal. How it is possible for eternal entities to have birth, appearance, or creation, etc.? If they appear at a certain time and did not exist before that, how does that confer eternity upon them? That is the question. Srila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving argument on by the mercy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, under his guidance, I can also try to explain something as a realization coming inside my heart by his mercy. First of all, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, time and space, matter actually, matter also, but Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, time and space as experienced in this material world is quite different from the time and space of that spiritual world. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, time and space as experienced in this material world is quite different from the time and space of that spiritual world. Material time is divided into three sections. Material time is divided into three sections like past, present and future. However, in the spiritual world, time is ever present and without any division. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. However, in the spiritual world, time is ever present and without division. All spiritual activities and the happenings of the transcendental realm are perceived in Vartaman, present. The present. Whereas, whatever incidents are normally experienced here in this, here in the material world, are rooted in the notions, conception. Notion means conception. In the notions of mundane time and space. When we discuss When we discuss spiritual subjects, Bhaktivinoda speaking, when, as and when we discuss any spiritual objects, and when we say things such as later the jiva became entangled with maya, the spiritual world was created, maya has no function in the creation of jiva, and so on, so on, so on. Whenever we are going to explain so many things about the eternal world, spiritual world, our words are being influenced by the concept of material time. Follow what I say. Bhaktivinoda speaking, whenever we are going to explain whatever way about eternal world, anyhow, our words are being influenced by the concepts of material time. Bhaktivinoda speaking, in our captive conditioned status, this influence is very likely, natural, quite natural. And to be expected, because without that explanation we cannot do, and nobody can understand. Your understanding depending upon your experience, previous experience. If there is no experience, if there is about such matter, transcendental matters, you have no experience, nothing at all, so how we can make you understand? That's why in Bhagavatam, Vyasadeva Goswami, Sukadeva Goswami, any, those who are writing Shastra, Mani Rishis, they are going to point out one thing, that it is not at all possible to specifically speak exactly anything which is spiritual. But it is called Digdarshan. In Sanskrit and Bengali we say Digdarshan, only we can say sun rises in the east. That doesn't mean sun east direction is the mother of sun god. Not that. Sun god going to give honor to that east direction. That much we can say. But we are bound to speak. It is not at all correct if you say sun rises in the east. Do you think sun, you know, east direction going to give birth? Not that. Similarly, all our Shastakar, those who are writing Shastra, our Guru Varga, our Vyasadevadi, they are going to speak that Vyasadeva Goswami also speaking. Only we can indicate, we can give some hint meaning indication. Exactly, it is not possible to represent that aprakita vastu in front of you. Follow. Only by example, whatever example coming near, whatever example can come approximately near to your understanding, approximately near to your understanding, whatever example, that we are searching to give you. Really impossible. In our captive condition status, this influence is very likely, natural, and to be expected. A hobby, it's a must. In all discussions about the jiva and the transcendence, our thoughts cannot be free from the concepts of mundane time, space, which is automatically going to enter in our deliberation whenever we are going to speak anything. This is inevitable. We talk and think in term of past, present and future. Also regarding dimension, those who are scientists or those who are having some minimum conception about physics and chemistry, they can understand. We understand three dimension: breadth, length, breadth and height. Who can say there is some place here in infinity universe Where is four dimension, five dimension? Who can say? Who can say? Like Mahaprabhu giving example to Sanatana from Bhagavatam. When Brahma going to meet with Bhagavan, then first of all, gate man going to inform to Bhagavan, Bhagavan, somebody coming to meet you. Who coming? You go and ask. But my name is Brahma. Then all demigods also following him. Then the servant, the gate man going to inform Bhagavan. Some Brahma coming, he told. Which Brahma? You go from which Brahma? Which Brahma? Then a servant, gate man coming, he said, which Brahma? Bhagavan asking, which Brahma? I thought I am only Brahma. Is there any other Brahma? Yes. Ultimately, going to indicate some Leela, indication. By this indication, he wanted to speak, I am coming from this Brahmanda. Bhagavan said, okay, then let him come. When Brahma going in front of Bhagavan, Brahma discover there is countless Brahma. Some having forehead like, no, I am only minimum forehead only. Some having 8, 16, 32 or thousands of face, How it is visible, Maharaj? Follow. Try to understand. When Bhagavan going to show his Vishwarup in front of Arjuna, why Bhagavan speaking with these eyes you cannot see? To see me, you need another eyes, spiritual, special eyes. What do you mean by that? Try to understand. Why you cannot see? We can see everything. Stool, urine, woman, this, that, and why not the? No, not possible. So there is some different, condition, environment. We cannot understand. So regarding dimension also, this question coming. Infinity world, we don't know. Here, it is applicable only three dimension. Which Brahmand, where, which dimension applicable, we don't know. Which time factor? Somebody fighting Maharaj in Sun, it is written in Shastra, all false, that in Sun God somebody going. And you idiot, why you speak like this and why? This world is relative world. You think you can bear up to 40 degrees Celsius temperature. You think nobody can. There can be some jiva, those their body is tejomai, mean a fiery body. Their body is so made of fire. Who can say? Tejomai body. So you are fighting. It is not applicable for you, for your material mind. So it is not possible. Foolish. Complete darshan is not there with Bhattaji. That's why they fight. Prabhupada never fight. Bhaktivinoda Thakur never fight. Because they can find solution. They are coming from that eternal world. They have direct experience. We don't have. So this way we should not fight. We should not fight. Gangama, water, by some spiritual figure. Jamuna Devi, as a spiritual figure. Saraswati, as a spiritual river, we say water. This kind of argument cannot stand. I already told. And a bonded soul can only fight. Whole life can go on fighting. No solution can come. So what Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, we should understand. In our captive conditioned status, this influence is very likely, natural, and to be expected. In all discussions about jivas and transcendence, our thoughts cannot be free from the concepts of mundane time and space, which is automatically enter into our deliberations. This is inevitable. We talk and think in terms of past, present and future. No other way. We are not habituated. However, when you consider the inner meanings of this topic, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that Raghunath Das Baba giving answer to that young man, Brajanath. However, Babaji Maharaj speaking, however, when you consider the inner meaning of this topic, try to keep in mind that a person who is solely searching for realization of the pure essence of the Absolute Truth will perceive and apply the concept of the eternal, ever-present time factor in her understanding of these topics. Jivatma Strilingo, that's why I am using her, in her understanding of these topics. He should deeply go into deep meditation of bhajan. We must be extremely cautious while deliberating upon this subject. Simply absorb yourself in the spiritual concept and reject the unavoidable mundane draws caused by the words. You will have to be careful about that. Follow. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur going to explain this way because no other way open. It is not possible for Bhaktivinoda to give. How possible? Bhaktivinoda Thakur can give kripa to us. We can start bhajan in such a way. Deep meditation of bhajan can unveil all the mystery there. But otherwise, there is no other way. So you see, it is impossible. So regarding time factor, I also like to discuss something. But first of all, I was speaking about, the topics what Prabhupada told. Prabhupada told the transformation of Shakti of a Supreme Lord creating these 14 worlds. Lord never undergo any influence by these three conditions like bondage condition, tatastha condition and free condition. Moreover, these three stages, bondage stage, tatastha stage and free stage, all the three stages have been derived from Him, from nowhere else, directly or indirectly. Supreme Lord, His external potency or Maya Shakti has been transformed as a material world. His internal potency has been transformed as Vaikuntha Jagat or Golaka or Ana. All those are beyond Maya. This internal potency and His external potency shown by Supreme Lord, in between both of them, there is another potency is called Tathastha Shakti, which has been transformed into countless Anu Chaitanya, infinity atomic particles of Chetan. Chetan means have some free will. Free will, they can take decision, everything. Otherwise, Chetan. Chetan means is a must. Chetan, I already told, Chetan Vastu, Atma, Purno Ganamoy, Push Purno Anandamoy, Purno Prakashmoy. I speak Sanskrit word and Bengali word, Purno Anandamoy. I mean, is coming from Supreme Lord. So, Ananda Amsa already there. Ananda Jeev Chetan Padattho. Chetan mean has some decision making power. Free will should be there. Otherwise, Chetan, useless. Chetan, if somebody going to fight, why Bhagavan not going to? And Bhagavan don't like to interfere with their free will. Bhagavan, it is one kind of playing. What Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking about this diversity of Maya, and some people fighting, why Bhagavan not going to find solution with our bonded soul? Bhagavan can easily do. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, yes, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, yes, Bhagavan can do, but cannot do. Why can do? If at all Bhagavan going to interfere with their free will, then the Leela is useless. It's become a material things. You know, factory product. But they are not factory product. Mama ibang sajiva loke jiva bhuta sanatana. So there, you know, since Anu Chaitanya Jivas are the transformation of Tatastha Shakti, so naturally they are suitable both for Chit Jagat and Maya Jagat. Try to understand. Since Anu Chaitanya Jivas are transformation of Tatastha Shakti, so originally, you know, Tatastha Shakti coming from the so naturally, they are suitable both for Chit Jagat and Maya Jagat. And Anu Chaitanya Chetan Jeev, I already told, full of knowledge, Gyanamoy, Anandamoy, and Prakashmoy. Follow, try to understand these three points. Gyanamoy means you need not import Gyan from outside. Gyanamaya Vastu, Gyanamaya Vastu, Chetanamaya Vastu, Gyanamaya Vastu, Anandamaya Vastu, Prakashmaya Vastu. Chetan mean Chaitanya. Chetan, when I speak, I must understand Chetan Vastu having eternal knowledge, eternal sarup. Gradually, day by day, I can try to prove eternal knowledge, eternal sarup. All I can, eternal exists everything. So, but I don't understand what is prakashmay. What do you mean by prakashmay? Follow. Chetanmay, chetanmay, obviously chetanmay. Chetanmay means gyanamay. Yeah. Anandamay. Chetan means ananda. Has a demand of enjoying. Natural, quite natural. A demand for enjoying. Is there? They enjoying different kind of enjoying can be there, material and spiritual, you know, seva enjoyment also there. So it depends. So, Gyanamay, Anandamay, and only by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, you will have to, the Jivatma, they can discover. It is already there. It is already there. When one bonded soul going to do bhajan and gradually in course of his bhajan going to increase, you know, consciousness, full consciousness, going to touch that param chetan vastu, nitto nityanam, chetanas chetanam, chetananam, ekobhunam, jobidodhati kaman, that purna chetan vastu. Mayavadi speaking all lie. They are going to prove, they are going to give evidence, false evidence in favor of ekatma. They are going to seek only Brahma is there. Brahma going to be reflected into, the, like one example. One sun god there in sky, and sun god there is countless water pot you can put in a ground. Each and every water pot, if you look, you can find some reflection of sun god there in the sky. Follow what I say. They are going to give this example. They are liar, speaking lie. They are going to speak that Brahma going to be reflected here, you know, Maya, and so diversity, where there is no diversity. They are not going to confess there is no diversity. Because diversity means even they are not ready to accept this tattva, Maya tattva. They think if we accept Maya tattva, then dual conception can come. Adhyayagan Tattva cannot stand. So they are not going to think. Someday if I discuss about the Mayavadi discussion under the guidance of, you know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, Kesava Goswami Maharaj, Baladeva Vidya, I can try to understand, try to make, you know, explain. It's very interesting. So, Anandamay surely, Chetanmay mean Anandamay, Gyanamay. Gyan is already there. Only the factor you will have to, only the thing you will have to obey, you have to do bhajan under the guidance of a Sadguru like Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, gradually you can get unveiled. It is already there, Gyan is already there. So, if at all there it is written in Vedanta, Gunad Alokbhat, Gunat qualitatively, qualitatively it is just like light rays. Just like, try to understand. It is just like light rays, not light rays, like. The face, the beautiful, the wonderful, you know, picture of Ramchandra, Tulsidas ji cannot compare with sun god, moon god, not possible. There is no comparable object in the world. But still, we find one Padma phool, lotus, lotus. Mukha Padma, Charan Padma, this much we can say. No other way. Because it's transcendental. When Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya could see Supreme Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in full form, he couldn't, because Bhagavan, you know, doing Leela like ordinary sannyasi. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu went to show in front of Sarvabhauma, the, you know, that I am actually Krishna, I am Ram, I am Gauranga, then Sarvabhauma gone mad. He couldn't bear that power, because there is Teja, base, big Teja. Like, if there is 220, if there is 220, you know, volt, that's okay. If there is 440 volt, then present wear, connection can melt. Non-conductor. Bonded souls are non-conductor of spiritual, you know, response. You know, but they can. Totally they can get, cannot get. But Chetan is there, that's why they can get, but they will have to try. They have to try. Fully they cannot get. So, non-conductor. But Chetan Vastu is there. That's why we can keep off. Someday we can understand. Someday we can feel. Now I like to explain this Prakashmai. Prakashmi? Prakashmin? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is going to give example. Same example I am going to give to you. Like Mahaprabhu was, you know, giving in front of Sanatana Goswami. Prakashmai. Prakashmai mean Atma, the Chid Atma, just like light particle, is like light particle, not like particle. Also, someday I can prove, I already told one sloka, that Anu Chaitanya Jeev, all sound particle, I can prove. Anu Shabda. Anadi Nidanam Brahmo Sabda Tattvam Jadaksharam Nivartate Artha Bhavena Pakriya Yagato Yataha. Someday I can prove, I can show you that it is like Latifgal Tejumai, but it is actually Anu Shabda. Prabhupada used to speak, we like to show our natural function. Natural function of Jiva is to sing all the time the glories of Supreme Lord. Prabhupada speaking, 24 hours we can stand under the lotus-like and leg of Guru Padpadman, go on singing continuously non-stop Harikatha. Anu Shabda, sound particle, naturally. What is the duty of sound particle? To make sound. Follow. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to prove Sankirtan Yajna. It is right, exactly. All other bhajan procedure, you can or cannot come out successful. It depends. But Sankirtan, if you do, 100%. Because Jivatma, how Anu Shabda, by this word, by the help of this word, from Bhagavatam and from different, you know, portion, Gita, many sloka I can discuss and prove that it is like light particle, but not light particle. Tejumai Vastu, to indicate. There's indication. Any spiritual matter, if we like to represent in front by you, we'll have to take help of some example. Because there is no, we cannot search any experience in our life. Impossible. Similarly, Prakashmai I like to understand, make you understand. Gyanamai, you know, Chetanamai, you know, Chetana is there. Chetanmaya means surely Gyanamaya. I already told. Gyanamaya and Anandamaya, of course. Otherwise, why you are running for enjoyment? Directly or indirectly, all jivasmas are always busy with enjoyment, material enjoyment. Directly or indirectly, they are busy with material enjoyment. Even in bhajan, they like to get some utility, material enjoyment. Absolute form of bhajan, nobody can reach up to that absolute form of bhajan. Only those Paramahansa Guru Vaishnav, they have direct realization. They know. They can give you realization provided you are inclined. You are busy with material things. They say, okay, let him be get busy with this material thing. What it concerns to me? Wastage of time. They are not ready to accept. You know, follow what I say. So, what Mahaprabhu is going to give example about Prakashmai. Prakashmai means one example I can give. Like fire, there is darkness inside your room. If you set fire in your fireplace, then fire going to give you heat energy, at the same time light energy. Follow. And you can get so many things. You can prepare something. You can boil something also. So many, you know, you can do. But one thing, when fire you are going to set fire, I mean, in your fireplace, is one place. But that fire going to give light. I mean, prakash is called prakash. Prakash means express some power, prakash. Similarly, chetan vastu, anandamaya vastu, chetan vastu, you know, gyanamaya vastu, atma, 100% you know, that it is there inside your body. That's why you are doing so many jobs, so many things. You are thinking, making, breaking, so many things you are doing. Simply because that Chidatma is there inside your body. Now point is then where and how the Chidatma stay. Mahaprabhu going to give example to Sanatan. Sanatan, one very, 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 very costly, you know, Malaya Chandan. Mahaprabhu in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Malaya Chandan is so costly, 100 gram it cost, you know, thousands of rupees. Very, very costly. Malaya Chandan. Madhavandi Puripat, you know, was bound to collect big Malaya Chandan to apply on the body of Gopinath, Kira Chora, you can remember? Kira Chora Gopinath. Yeah. So now Mahaprabhu giving example, Sanatan. When somebody going to apply this, you know, this Malaya Chandan, one drop, only you can try in your life. Only one drop of Malaya Chandan, if you apply on your forehead, whole day you can feel some cooling, you know, you can feel some cooler going on inside your body. Cooler, AC. Mahaprabhu giving the example, Sanatan. If somebody is going to apply this chandan, Malaya Chandan drop on her forehead, whole day can feel a soothing energy, very, very cool. Mahaprabhu giving this example for Atma. Atma is there inside heart, but Atma, you can understand how you can understand by Prakash. All limbs, all tissue, all limbs, all tissue, each and every drop of your blood going to get influenced by the mercy of that Chidatma. If Chidatma going out, then all activities stop. All tissues, all limbs, all drop of blood, all useless. That's why in Upanishad it is written, Atma va are drashtabhya sratabhya nididhyasitabhya. Follow. Try to understand this. In Upanishad it is written, Atma va are drashtabhya sratabhya nididhyasitabhya. What do you mean by this sloka? Atma va are drashtabhya. Atma can be seen. Really? Yes. So infinitesimal, how we can see? Ah, that is the question. Nayam atma parvachanena nobhyo, no midhaya no bhuno, situino, jam eva eshat. you know, Vrinite Tena Labhyo, this sloka. Impossible to see, but can be seen. You will have to prepare your eyes. You'll have to take preparation to see all things, you know, there in transcendental world. You have to prepare your eyes. Guru Padma can act as magnifying glass or, you know, transparent media. I can discuss this point tomorrow. How? So this way we can see what is what exactly. If we are going to get full kripa of Sadguru, Guru Parampara, Prabhupada, Bhakti Muntago, surely they are waiting to give kripa. I am sitting in Vyasasana, I promise you, they are waiting to give kripa. But we are not going to take kripa. That's why. There is kapat bhav. 100% if you demand kripa, and if kripa not coming, it cannot so happen. It can never so happen. Impossible. Kripa can come, 100%. If demand is there, supply can be made. As the economics is formula. If demand is there, supply can be met. Follow what I say. So Prakashmaya Vastu, giving this example, like the fire inside your room, the light, you know, it's, you know, going to radiate light everywhere, we can see everything as it is. Similarly, Atma, due to Atma, some prakash, emitting some powers, emitting some excellent, you know, thing, by the help of which we can do our activities, we can find all everything useful. If you are going to give me huge amount of diamond, but if my body gone, now what I can do with this diamond? We find utility of any object in relation to this material world. If I send you into exile, there is nobody else, only you. You know, exile in Ireland. I can give enough amount of gold coin, you know, diamond, everything. What you can do? Same thing, na? Janme Joy crying and writing letter to, you know, here, our, you know, Bajranabha. Bajranabha writing letter, see what I can do? Because Vrindavan, when Bhagavan finished Leela here, everything changing. Nobody can understand. Vajranabha speaking, you are making king here. You are going to make king here in Vrindavan. Well, I am king for what reason? Who is there? So that I can rule? Some monkey there? You make me king here in Vrindavan. For who is going to care, Maharaj? I am king or not king, beggar. Then ultimately some Brahmans, huge amount of Brahmans, they were sent with some commitment, I mean facilities, so that if they can shift there in Vrindavan, they can enjoy so many land and properties, they can, this way, you know, when Krishna gone after that newly, the civilization there in Vrindavan, it is eternally present, but still, like Ayodhya, when Bhagavan gone, above Dham, Bhagavan taking everybody from here. Then Haridas Thakur, Mahaprabhu discussing, and Haridas, if all Jivas gone, then where from no new Jiva coming? Haridas going to answer, Prabhu, actually there is countless Baddha Jivas, Bhagavan going to, you know, according to their, you know, Karmapal, Bhagavan going to put them here. You know, it's all inside a hand. Karma seed, try to understand. I know you are feeling confusion, so many topics, but still you have to keep patience. That day I told the discussion by Baladev Vidyabhushan, that ultimately everything, though Bhagavan is not responsible, still the ultimate thing is there, the key is there inside the hand of Bhagavan. Like karma seed is there inside you, but karma seed cannot get, you know, a sprout cannot come out. Like if there is no rain, I am going to throw, you know, sheet should be there. If I bow sheet at the same time without rain, only if sunlight is there, scorchy sunlight, then sheet cannot show sprout. follower, I say. So, sprouting depend upon rainfall. Rainfall in the hand of Varun, I mean Indra. Indra in the hand of Krishna. All ultimately, all, you know, key. If one switch is off, then another all switch blockage. Ultimately, young Brahma Varunendra Ruddhamaruto Stumbanti. Why they are going to, you know, going to glorify? Because there is no other way. All excellences, they are lying in the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. Who but the jeev can express false ego? I am this, I am that. But all finish within second. Follow. So this way I can prove that ultimate thing is there inside a hand. Okay, karma seed is there with jiva. But jiva, seed is there. But seed cannot show sprout until and unless there is rain. No rain, no sprout. So ultimate reason is there inside the hand of Bhagavan. Follow what I say. This way, prakashmay mean have some influence, prakash, and express something. It's an abnormal thing, inexplicable. I cannot explain. What that Atma, Atini Atma, sitting inside the heart, going to express what kind of power? What time expression? You know? We cannot explain. Only this much we can say, all meaningful due to the presence of this Atma. This much I can say. This much I can say, no more. Only for this Atma, because of this Atma is there inside a body, all we find meaningful. This flat, this property, this land, this, all is. If spirit gone, useless. Atma va are drashtabbo srotabbo nidhi. Then it is in this sloka, I can explain someday, that it is written in Upanishad, Atma va are drashtabbo. Atma can be seen. Next, speaking Atma va are drashtabbo srotabbo. Sotabha means can be heard. Atma can be heard. Atma? What you say? Is a strange? No strange. Atma va are drashtabha srotabha. You can hear the presence of Atma. Atma va are drashtabha srotabha. Nididhyasa, you have to concentrate on this Atma. Why you are looking outside? In Gita class you are speaking, na? Nate vidu swartha gatim hi Vishnu dura sayaje bahir arthaman andha yathande rupaniyamanam teyopi sichatanta murudam nibadya. I told, na, we all looking outside. None of us habituated to look inside because lack of kripa. Why a sadhu is so satisfied? Only two breads there, no arrangement, nothing, no facility, nothing. They are feeling always drinking nectar. How? Whereas you are feeling dissatisfaction. What can be the reason? Any situation you can try. Any situation in which they are put into, they can feel satisfied. You know? Follow. Even some jivatma going to speak all rubbish. Yesterday, the wife of our doctor, Chapati, speaking all rubbish against me. All nonsense. With full bearing I'm hearing. Let her see. You are going to destroy everything. You are going to break my family. Yes. Okay. I cannot fight with people. But still I am happy. If I am not happy, if I am not satisfied, how I can speak Harikatha? So I never mind. Some people can speak, give honor. Some people can speak all rubbish against me. Somebody can abuse me. Somebody can take away something from me. Is they can do. They are allowed to do. It is the testing of Krishna. Okay. Let them do. Yeah. This way, this material world is full of problem, but still Guru Vaishnava thing, it is there everywhere transcendental bliss prevailing. No problem. Where you say? Where you say? Vishwam purana sukhayate. This whole world is full of bliss. Where do you find problem? Foolish? No problem there. This way you will have to feel. So Atma can be seen, Atma can be heard. I can speak about Atma also. Atma, I can consider on Atma, not outside. Nate vidusartha gotim he Vishnu durasayaje bahirarthamanin andhayathandhairupaniyamanam teyo pisichatanta murudam nivadhya. Pallatma speaking. Those material people, bonded soul, always going to search outside. They are always traveling around this Panchal Kheto, five fields. Panchal is a land of Draupadi Devi. But Panchal means Punjab. Panchal also mean Panchal also means five different fields of enjoyment. Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha. Bonded soul always going to travel around these five fields. Follow what I say. That's why Prahladma speaking, they are always traveling outside. Their material mind, they cannot check their material mind, and they are always searching outside to get enjoyment. But sadhu, real sadhu, always getting enjoyment inside. Outside there is no enjoyment. All is inside. Follow. If you do seva perfectly, you can feel some transcendental bliss. Here, Harikatha, you can bliss. If there is aparadh, then you cannot feel negative. What to do? Aparadh can, you know, if you do aparadh, then your consciousness can drop, go down. If you do aparadh, then consciousness can go down. You cannot feel. That means surely you will have to understand, I know that there is some aparadh. Why I am losing consciousness? Why I am not enjoying? You know, seva mood. You know, this way. So prakash, you understand this? Prakash means by the presence of that Atma, such excellent influence of Atma is there inside whole body. Each and every limb, each and every tissue, cytoplasm, chromosome, protoplasm, everything there. All, each and every ribonucleic acid, everything, or everywhere, the influence of Atma. That's why whole body moving, we are thinking, we are swing. But actually, Chetan Atma has no connection with this material world. Previously also I tweet, simply because for infinity period, Purusha and Prakriti staying. Purusha means the Atma. Chida. Purush, two type of Purush. One is Param Purush, Paramatma. Another Purush is Jivatma. They both staying. I can discuss this point from Shetasatara Upanishad. From Shetasatara Upanishad, I can discuss this point. That how these two bosom friends, Jivatma and Paramatma, eternal friend, we cannot develop any friendship here in the material world because already we have eternal friend who is never going to leave me. Never, 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 infinity time. Paramatma. From Shetasatara Upanishad, I can discuss this point. Follow. How Jivatma, Paramatma going to stay, you know, with each other, never going to leave. In Vrindavan, some Pandit asking me, if Jivatma going to hell, Maharaj, then Paramatma can also go. Then I put question that, what do you mean by hell and heaven? And for treatment, if Jivatma going, because it is a must. If you are doing wrong job, you have to treatment, you have to go to Jamala, hell. And in hell, Paramatma also watching the painful condition of Jivatma, his friend. Always watching. Oh my God! Who told you to bear this kind of suffering? I never told. I told you come to me, enjoy your life. But you are forcefully going there. So you are suffering. Then at the time of suffering, when Jivatma, you know, getting punishment there in hell, Paramatma also watching. Paramatma still then Paramatma not going to leave friend. A friend in need is a friend indeed. At the time of painful situation, if my friend is not there with me, what kind of friend he is? Follow. Bharati Maharaj used to speak one, sloka, spoken by Chanakya. Rajadari sasa necha, sankati. So one sloka, very nice. He is actually friend. So now about time factor I speak, about the excellency of Jivatma, and excellent, I am discussing. So Mahaprabhu giving the example of this, chandan, malaja chandan, which is going to put influence whole all over the body. Though the chandan drop is there only in forehead, but a whole body I am feeling kuri. Same, you try to guess, try to understand. So, another thing is very spectacular, that Jivatma being eternal by nature, when going to attain Siddha Deha, suppose one Jivatma going to do bhajan and now is going to enter into Siddha. In this respect, I like to discuss the topics written by Prabhupada about, Billa Mangal Thakur. I like to discuss this point. I already told the Billa Mangal Thakur about Billa Mangal Thakur, the symptom of a sadhak. Why Rupa Goswami Pad going to write in Rasamrita Sindhu this sloka? Why? And going to give this example of Billa Mangal Thakur. That I like to. Today, you try to understand very carefully. Rupa Goswami Pad giving the example, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Utpanno Ratayo Samyak, Samyak Nairvignam Anupagataha Krishna Sakshat Kritau Yajnaha Sadhakaha Parikirtita. Utpanna Ratayo. They are coming up to the point of Rati. Very nice. But still, different kind of problem, impediments, still there in the way of their bhajan. Follow, try to understand. Utpanna ratayoho sammak nairvignam anupagataha. Nairvignam anupagataha. Nirvignam means flawless bhajan is not there. Still, there is impediments, problems. Krishna sakshatkar kitau yogya. They are qualified to meet with Krishna. But of course, it depends upon Krishna. They are sadhaka parikirtita. Sadhaka in final stage. Not that sadhaka, you start bhajan and then speak this sloka now applicable. Sadhaka, when in full and topmost condition, utpanna ratayo, he is already developing rati, but still today, all different kind of problems, he is not free. That jivatma, is not free, totally, of problem. Problem is there. Different kind of impediments can come. And Krishna Sakkarka Krito Yajna. He can, that Jivatma can meet with Krishna. Of course, it depends upon Krishna. Sadhaka Parikit. This is called Sadhak. Now, actually, Rupa Goswami Pad going to give the example of Billa Mangal Thakur. Billa Mangal Rasamrita Sindhu, Rupa Goswami Pad writing. Billa Mangalatulla Je Sadhaka Ste Prakirtitaha. Follow. Rupa Goswami Pad directly writing. Billa Mangala Tulla Je Sadhakaha Ste Parikitrita. Like the example of Billa Mangal Thakur is applicable for all sadhak. Those were actually sadhak. Follow. But here is one doubt, Maharaj. Billa Mangal Thakur we find on dirty history. Billa Mangal Thakur, previous history is very dirty. Jada kama, material kama, so many problems we know, you heard? Yes, you know. Villamangal Thakur, his previous life we find due to material enjoyment or so many things, you know, we... But when? Advaita Vidipati Koi Ananda Singhasana Labdha, this sloka I can discuss someday. But when he is going to develop total detachment from material thing, suppose one is busy with big enjoyment, someday for some reason, somehow we develop total detachment. Follow what I say. Total enjoyment mood, bogey, total detachment. Follow. Both enjoyment and detachment we don't need. We don't need. What we can do? We like to do seva. So, when Billamangal Thakur going to develop total detachment, preliminary, he was feeling Advaitabad Asakti. Advaitabad. Follow. First of all, Advaita Vidipatakai Sananda Singhasana Labdha. This. So, first of all, when he is going to feel total detachment, preliminary, first stage, he was feeling Advaita by Asakti. He was feeling, you know, attraction for, you know, Advaitabad. Kintu, but when going to throw out all the topics of Chintamani association, when going to throw away all Advaita Bithi, the track of Advaitabad, when under the guidance of Sadguru, by the mercy of Krishna, you know, by the mercy of Krishna. Chintamani Nama Jayati. This Chintamani is Krishna, not that Chintamani Pras. Don't get confused. Sometime Bhagavan, so many, you know, things are there. Bhagavan, if somehow Bhagavan becomes satisfied, can give extraordinary power. When he is going to throw out this Chintamani topics of, you know, pras topics and Advaitabhat, all under the guidance of Sadguru, Krishna Seva Ras going to cover up whole heart. When his heart going to overflow with Krishna Seva Rasa, continuous non-stop, then we cannot confuse. I can discuss this point, but first of all, I like to remind you, you can remember the case of Jagai Madai. You can go through Chaitanya Bhagavad. I know you are not going. You can find there, when by the request of Nityananda Balaram Jagadguru, Anantadev, Mahaprabhu going to somehow bestow kippa on Jagai Madai, then after that, Jagai Madai is very clever. He is asking for seva. How we can know that you are very satisfied? Give seva. Guru Vaishnava satisfied means they are giving seva. That means satisfied, satisfaction. Now, Mahaprabhu giving warning to everybody. Be careful. Same example I can give here. Mahaprabhu going to sing. Be careful. Don't try to speak anything relating to their previous life. So many contamination was there in their life. Now eternal future of their life is just open. Material body and material mind, they are doing all rubbish thing. But from now onward, nobody can speak anything relating to their past dirty history. Be careful. Don't speak anything about their past history. Now, they are new. Their eternal future open. Follow what I say. So here also, now onward we cannot speak anything about Billamangal Thakur dirty history. When now Billamangal Thakur going to show overflowing rasa coming out of his heart, continuously, non-stop. He is the writer of Krishna Karnamrita, which is the topmost treasure of devotional world. At least Mahaprabhu is going to show this point. He is the writer of Mahaprabhu, when I can discuss at the time of Gaur Purnim, that Nilachala Mahaprabhu, I can show you Mahaprabhu speaking, He Rai, He Sarup, this writing is not at all writing. Mahaprabhu himself speaking, He Rai Mahasaya, He Sarup, the writings in this Karnamrita is not at all writing. It is his direct feeling. Whatever he is looking, what he is watching in this direct access in Leela, Radha Govinda Leela. Mahaprabhu speaking this way. Sarup, surely, is a direct feeling. It is direct feeling of, you know, of the writer, Kabi. Oh, impossible. This way, Mahaprabhu is going to explain. Now try to understand the mood of Mahaprabhu. What Mahaprabhu want to say? The Karnamrita, all the 24 hours in the later on life in Nilachal, you know, follow. Mahaprabhu stayed there at home 24, and the rest renounced order 24. Out of that, 12 years here and there, 6. And another 12 years continues there doing Leela inside Nilachaldam. Nilachaldam na Gambira also inside. Exclusive Leela, to teach us what is called exclusive Raganuga Bhajan. He is going to show us that we should not be Sahajiya to show we are doing Raganuga Bhajan. Mahaprabhu wanted to teach us exclusive Bhajan. He is called Raganuga. I cannot forget the pain of losing, you know, one penny. I can do Raganuga Bhajan. Oh my God, you are going to make fool of me. Now when Krishna Rasayan, Krishna Karnamrita coming out of the heart of Krishna, this Villamangal Thakur, it is Krishna Indriya Toshan Karini Vani Shevak. Now onward he is going to Bhakti Siddhanta Sampo. Bhakti Siddhanta totally get manifested inside heart. There is no shortage. He is getting in connection with Anantadev. No shortage there. If Anantadev not there, then shortage. Ananta is there, then fulfill. Purna sapurna madaya purna meva vasishyati. Then Jagadguru Lilava Mahaprabhu, all going to give full honor to Billamangal Thakur to show that now we can see the eternal feature of Billamangal Thakur. Eternity is not such a, you know, prejudicial conception. Eternity, what is eternity? I will have to discuss from Piti Sandarbha to show you how Sarupe Sabar Hai Golokita Siddhi. From Piti Sandarbha, next day tomorrow I can discuss that how Jivatma going there, getting suitable body, and Bhaktivinoda Thakur what speaking, all need discussion. Inside Billamangal Thakur, expressing the fullest, you know, flow of that Krishna Rasayan. Krishna himself satisfied. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu means Krishna. Follow what I say. Jagannath is very happy with, you know, Vidya, our Kavi, Jayadev Kavi, Git Govinda. Jagannath daily like to hear Git Govinda. Without that, Jagannath cannot sleep. Now point. One day, I forget the name of that time king. King thought, I am king, I can also write Git Govinda. He was writing. In the morning time, When Pujari opened the door, find the Git Govinda Jagannath going to kick. Jagannath going to kick that Git Govinda. He scattered all over. Follow. But the Git Govinda originally written by Jayadev Goswami, Jagannath laughing and hearing. Jagannath is very, very happy to hear. Hey, daily, without hearing Git Govinda, Jagannath not going to take rest. Follow. Now you think about. When the total, you know, full-fledged expression of Vaishnavata, full-fledged expression of Siddhanta Vichar, full-fledged expression of Rasatatta, going to flow. Then, in that case, we cannot say that previously he was this kind of character. No, no. But that was related to two material body. He is going to express full eternity there. Now, again I can discuss this. Okay, I know it is not clear to you. Still, I like to discuss this point. And now, actually, also another thing is very spectacular, that any jivatma, that jivatma being eternal by nature, when going to attain siddhi, siddha deha, when a bada jiv going to get siddha deha, to enter into eternal jagat, then automatically her means jivatma, that jivatma, her previously existing suppressed eternity can get manifested. Follow. Eternity. Okay. And how? From Piti Sandarbha I can show you. Srila Jivapad writing in Piti Sandarbha. What kind of, you know, nice discussion I can do tomorrow. Now another point. If you have any minimum conception about mathematics, higher mathematics, calculus, this, that. So you hear this point, tends to zero, tends to infinity, this conception you hear. You have no direct experience about infinity. Only you are habituated to speak infinity, infinity, infinity you can speak. But you have no direct experience about infinity. When Anantadev going to make you feel, when by the blessings of Anantadev, you can go mad. Who? Like Arjun gone mad by watching the Vishwarup. Prasidha, Prasidha Jagannath. Hey Jagannath, be peaceful. I don't like to see it. No, I like to see, you know, Tenoiva Chaturbhujarup. I like to see your forehand, club wheel, Padma. No, I don't like to see this horrible. Oh, infinity world. Infinity world. Oh my God. No. So Arjun couldn't bear. By the mercy of Nityananda Anantadev, we can have some feeling about Anantadev. You can, if you can make friendship with Anantadev, then any prejudicial idea, very small, very dirty idea cannot stand. Anantadev Kepa. Follow. So, Jivatma going to enter into eternal Jagat, then her previously unexpressed eternity, Jivatma itself eternally present, but his unexpressed eternity due to Maya just going to be removed. Then, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I can give example. Again, I can discuss tomorrow what Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to speak. Infinity, infinity, going to submerge into infinity. Previous day I told, one drop of Ganga, one drop of ordinary water I throw into Ganga, it becomes Ganga water. Eternal Jiva, when getting Siddhi, I going to throw, and on that eternal time period going to throw, it become eternal. Because eternal mean infinity plus infinity is equal to infinity. Minimum mathematics if you know, minimum. infinity plus infinity is equal to infinity. Infinity minus infinity is equal to also infinity. There is no possibility of, you know, adding something, calculation, because infinity. Infinity plus infinity, infinity. Infinity minus infinity, infinity. Nothing material there in the eternal dham. Even a dust particle there in Chinmay dham, eternal world itself, complete by nature. Whereas you, not complete, I am not complete. But whereas a dust particle from that, you know, eternal world is also complete. More and more valuable than infinity material world. One dust particle, you know, in Chinmay dham. So nothing material there in eternal dham. Even a dust particle there is Chinmay, eternal, and itself complete by nature. Sri Krishna is the absolute player, sportsman, with divine sportive attitude, and we all are, everything are the items of his divine playing. He is playing with all Jivatma. According to his free will, he can play with us, good or bad, whatever the result can be there, not to be blamed. I can discuss what Bhaktivinoda Thakur want to speak about diversity, about this kind of playing with Baddha Jiva, or I can discuss tomorrow, you can understand very clearly. Follow what I say. Try to understand the, you know, Krishna Sarup. Mahaprabhu to Sanatan Goswami speaking, Sanatan, Krishna Sarup, if somebody can understand the Krishna Sarup, he can go mad. They can become speechless. What is Krishna? You are habituated to play your brain, material brain. Krishna Sarup, Sanatan, if somebody going to know the exact thing of Krishna Sarup, they can go mad. Who is Krishna? Oh my God. They have no experience. That's why they are always trying to pass judgment, fighting. Oh, how possible? How possible? How possible? And how possible? Try to do bhajan. Try to do bhajan and try to realize yourself. Why you are depending? You have to depend on Guru Vaishnava. Don't waste your time. Try to do bhajan and try to realize. Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving argument, I can show you. You know. How Krishna is Karunamay, Krishna is Leelamay. You know. I can discuss better tomorrow. Today you cannot digest so many things. I think Krishna, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, what Bhaktivinoda Thakur told. Krishna is Karunamay, but he is also Leelamay. Dynamic and eternally engages in pastimes with the view that the Jiva could become an active partner of his various Leelas, the Supreme Lord has made her versatile and capable of rising from her humble position as a marginal being to the soaring heights of Mahabhava. I can discuss tomorrow. Today you will have to think again and again. If you find some question or doubts, you must express. Otherwise my seva is not complete. If you are not, you know, going to understand, follow. This is Bani Seva. I am a servant of my Guru Varga. Try to satisfy Guru Varga by this Bani Seva. This much I can say. And you will have to wait with full patience to hear all about this Jiptatta from different angle. It will take long time from different. Jang Bhamma Varunendaru Dhamaruto Stunmanti Dibbaistavai Vedai Shanga Padakrama Upanishadai Gayanti Yam Samaga dhyanavastita tadgatena manasa pashyanti yam yogina yasyam tam na vidusura suragana devaya tasmai namaha. Vanchakalpatarvasya kipasindu bhavishya patitanang pavana bhavishna bhyo namo namaha.